Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video we're gonna see about Ruchi Soya Industries Limited. As we said on February 14th, the results has came out for Ruchi Soya Industries Limited. So basically, before going into this result segment, we want to say an important news about Ruchi Soya Limited is that the share consolidation has been happened in the ratio of 100:1. So before, if you are holding 100 shares, now you would be left holding one share. So guys, I think it is a very, very good news for those people, because its result is absolutely amazing and the amount of profit they have earned will definitely make you aware. So without a second, let us go to the result guys. And this is the result. I mean, the pages has been in inverse type, but we will convert and say this because it would be a lot full helpful for you guys. And moving on, the results we are going to see is very, very good, because since the amount are given in lakhs, we want to say it into crores so that it could help you guys. As you can see here, they are expressed in lakhs here, so we want to say in crores. So the total income is coming around 3700 crores is the revenue. I mean, if you compare previous quarter, it is 3100 crore, and previous year it is 3500 crore. So that is a beautiful jump in the amount of revenue. So profit before all expenses are given 15,000 lakhs, which is nothing but 151 crore. So 151 crore is the amount of profit they have earned. So guys, if you notice, previous quarter the profit is around 81 crores, you can see here guys. And this is a main point you should note here, because the amount of profit they have earned is very, very good. And the exceptional items are given, refer note 4. We will see the note 4. But the exceptional amount coming around to 7,46,606 lakhs, which is nothing but 7,617 crores is the amount of profit before tax. And so the total profit is coming around 7,600 crore. The EPS is now around 3,947. The highest EPS to be held by any company in Indian history, you can see guys. But it is not the real profit, because you should see the exceptional item 4. The original profit the company has earned is just 151 crore. But you should note that, the Ruchi Soya Industries Limited, or you can say Ruchi Soya Industries or Ruchi Soya Limited, any name. This company was acquired by Patanjali Ayurveda Limited, as you all know. So the capital reduction process, tax expenses adjustment, deferred tax adjustments is being conducted. So I think it will be in exception 4. So now let us go to the exception item 4, so that we could have a knowledge about it guys. So moving down, we can see about this exception item. We will turn this page because we want to see it clearly. Since they have said this point number 4, let us see about this point number 4, because they have said the exception items come under point 4. So they have said that exceptional items net for the quarter comprises of deed recognition of liabilities amounting to as said in 2.E. So this, we want to see this 2E or so, sir, guys. And second thing is that impairment of refund receivable against commercial tax that I told before yourself, guys. I mean, I said the deferred tax adjustments and the tax adjustment they have done due to this capital reduction process and takeover of this company. So let us go now and see this 2E point, so that we could get a view about it also. So this is the point 2, and in point 2, what is the E point, let us see guys. And in point E, they have said that in respect of de-recognition of operational and financial creditors, difference amounting to 7,51,934, that means 7,500 crores is the amount of financial creditors and operational creditors between is, and also it's recognized in the profit or loss statement in accordance with Ind AS 109. So what that means guys, I will explain it clearly. Because of insolvency process, well, due to the NCLT route, the operations, the creditors should be classified under financial creditors and operational creditors. Once the problem is over, as per Ind AS 109. So what is Ind AS, if you ask me guys? Ind AS is nothing but an accounting policy or accounting framework followed, that should be followed by company in order to present the accounts in a correct manner with the correct meaning. So what this accounting standard says is that if through the NCLT process the financial creditors and the operational creditors have been done, this amount should be recognized in the profit or loss statement. Now let us go and see the profit or loss statement so that you could get a view about it, guys. So if you go to the profit and loss statement, you can see here, guys. I mean, the page is inverted, but the amount, as you can see here, guys, 7,61,000 here. That is the amount of the creditors amount they are showing in an exceptional item. So which made this company to show a profit of 7,600 crore. So without that effect, the amount of profit is coming around 151 crore. So that is an operational improvement in this company, guys. And also, you should note that in respect of derecognition of financial credits, they have said, and also they said that out of the funds received 4,35,000 crore, mean 4,35,000 lakhs, that means 4,350 crore, that is we use for settlement of creditors amounting to 11,500 lakhs, and also improvising the operations of company. That means now what they are trying to say means Patanjali has given 4,350 crores for acquisition of this company, Soya Industries Limited. So what they are trying to say means out of the amount they have got, they have said that they want to pay back the creditors and as well as improve the operational efficiency so that it could help the company to grow. So basically what they are trying to say in a conclusive manner, guys. So how this result has impacted Ruchi Soya Industries Limited, I think this will continue on upper circuit, guys. But remember, due to the capital reduction process, it should at least be in the range of 250 to 300 in order to get at least the capital back. The second thing is that Baba Ramdev in the Patanjali Group and also the Ruchi Soya Industries Limited said that the company is aiming for a turnover of 50,000 crore in a period of 2 to 3 years. Which means the shareholders who have lost their money in this capitalization process would be really benefited due to that process, guys. And this is about Ruchi Soya Industries Limited. So the revenue is around 3,000 of crores and the profit is around 151 crores. So after exceptional items coming around 7,600 crores. And this is about Ruchi Soya Limited. If you have enjoyed this video till now, then click the subscribe button because you could get our latest updates regarding many shares daily. Thank you, guys.